Hey, Daniels, you've really done a good day's work, haven't you? First you get us a cell search, then we miss half our lunch break, and now we've got the screws breathing down our necks. What are you going to give us tomorrow? Leprosy?
Fair go, I said I'm sorry.
Well, tell it to your mates. If there's no more joints, they'll know who to blame. Now listen to me, everyone. I can make life a whole lot easier for you. I can get you grass, pills, maybe even coke. Booze too, if that's your bag. Only I've got to know that you're with me and that you're going to do it my way. Well, what do you reckon?
I haven't done this before then.
Well, not for a while. I've been working in a supermarket, demonstrating makeup, that sort of stuff.
They move you around, don't they?
Pardon?
Still, all these jobs will come in handy if they ever decide to make you an undercover cop, eh?
Sorry, don't understand.
No, of course you wouldn't. Got to go, I've got a customer waiting. Excuse me, madam, can I help you?
Oh, I don't know. What do you reckon?
Hey. Crikey, B. Don't look now. That woman over there, she's an undercover cop.
All right, Doreen, calm down.
Get out of here.
Leave now. It'll just look worse. She'll follow me. Yeah, well, I haven't decided what I want yet. I thought I might just pick a few out and try them on, if that's all right.
Ah, oh, well, see if there's anything you like, and I'll be with you in a moment.
Thanks.
Why don't you look after these ladies here, and I'll look after that one? Well, you are here to work, aren't you?
Yes.
I still don't think we looked thoroughly enough. It was marijuana, Meg. I could smell it.
Well, all we can do is keep an extra sharp eye on McKenzie.
She may try to bring some more in, though. Mrs. Davidson wants everything that's brought in thoroughly searched.
Well, that'll slow things down a bit. We haven't got the staff to cope.
They can't get away with it.
What?
Oh, Dobson, what's wrong?
Oh, my God, look at her arms.
Did you do this to yourself?
Get her up under the tent.
Come on. Come on, you've got to get it off. You're burning up. Come on. Stop struggling. It's for your own good.
Oh, what on earth made you do such a dreadful thing?
I just want to get rid of it.
You can't get rid of tattoos like that, you stupid little fool. All you've done is burnt yourself.
It worked.
Look, I'll get in touch with Wentworth General. She better get there straight away.
God, you're right. With her. Come on, we'll get them seen to. We may not have done too much damage.
It didn't work.
Okay, you lot, stop work. I've just figured out what we're going to do about the dope.
Well, I don't see what we can do. The screws will be searching everything that goes near that dump.
That's right, they will. And I'm going to give them something to really get their hot little paws on.
But what do you mean?
Well, it stands to reason. I've got to lie low for a while. But in that time, we'll get the screws so mixed up, they won't know what's going on.
Oh, yeah. And how are we going to do that?
We'll contact our mates and ask them to send things into us.
What kind of things?
Oh, soft toys, tea bags, anything that looks as if it might have dope in it.
I don't see what good that's going to do.
Plenty. They've got to search the stuff, don't they?
Hey, yeah. Only they won't find nothing.
That's right. We'll keep the stuff rolling in, and they'll be running around in circles, working their little butts off for nothing.
Sounds okay to me.
Right. And when they've got tired of finding nothing, I'll start bringing in the dope again.
What a little ripper. They'll think we're getting the stuff in, but they won't know how.
We did all right with our dope before. Things have changed around here, Birdbrain. You're living in the past. Well, everyone with me?
Geez, it won't hurt, Lizzie. And anyway, it's about time we did a bit of decent screw baiting.
Good.
Well, I'll call Roxy, ask her to send me in a prezi. She'll be in it.
And I'll contact me old mate Bill and ask him to fix up something that'll really get the screws chasing their tails.
Sorry, B. I took so long because I got tied up with a customer.
Oh, that's all right.
Oh, geez, I was worried about you, you know, breaking out and all that.
No need to worry about me.
Well, it's good to see you, though. You are okay, aren't you?
Yeah, fit as a fiddle. Looking pretty dangerous yourself.
Well, I knew that you'd come to me sooner or later, but what took you so long?
I knew they'd be watching you. I didn't want to get you into any strife.
Well, you can stay with me as long as you like. You know that, and we'll find a way to fool those cops.
Look, thanks, love, but no thanks. It's too risky.
Yeah, but I got this...
Forget it. We'll never get away with it. Besides, you're not going back inside for me.
I've got to do something to help. How are you off for money?
As a matter of fact, I'm pretty skint. I had a fair bit of cash that weren't getting to Sydney. I've got a couple $100 from the old bag I was working for. That'll be gone soon.
Food is so bloody expensive.
Is it ever? Well, how much do you need?
I hate to ask you for it, but just enough for me to, you know, keep going and set off somewhere new.
Well, I'll go and see how much I've got in my bag. Look, try these on in case that sneaky Megan's hanging around.
Okay.
That woman in there is certainly taking her time, isn't she?
Oh, yes. But you know what some of them are like. Real picky. You can't rush them, though.
I suppose not. Look, it's time for your coffee break. I'll look after her if you like.
Oh, my coffee break can wait.
I don't mind.
No, but she might. She looks the sort that might complain if she gets bobbed off onto somebody else. And you've got to keep the customers happy. Well, I said I'd get her another dress. It's a bigger size. You know what they're like, real vain, trying to squeeze into something that won't fit them.
Oh, I see.
Look, you better take something and go. That cop's starting to ask funny questions.
What do you reckon she's onto us?
Well, not yet, but she will be if you stay around much longer, snoopy bitch.
Right.
Here.
Love.
I know it's not very much, but the bank's closed and I'll get more for you tomorrow.
That could be a hassle. I can't come back here. And your shadow will follow you everywhere.
I thought of that. I'll get rid of her.
Easier said than done.
Well, I'll think of something. I've already thought of a place for us to meet.
Where?
The State Theatre tomorrow afternoon. Do you know where it is?
I'll find it.
Well, I thought the 5 o'clock session because not many people go to that.
Okay, I'll be there.
Right, well, I'll meet you inside. Now go to the dress circle and go down near the front.
All right, you're on. That's an awful lot of money to be carrying around, huh?
Yeah, well, I thought of that too. You just keep the carry bag from the shop and bring it with you tomorrow.
Why?
Well, I'll bring another carry bag with the money in it and we'll swap them during the picture.
Oh, good one, Doreen. Couldn't do better myself.
Doreen, we have customers waiting out here.
Oh, yeah, come in, Mrs. Dennis. I better get out there before the old bugger comes in. Do you reckon this'll fit you?
Yeah, why not?
Well, I'll whip it into a bag and put the money in the till later.
Why can't I just nick it?
You'll get caught, that's why. See these things they put on the dresses nowadays? Well, the alarm goes off as you go through the door.
Yeah? Boy, haven't I been out of it for a while.
Doreen!
I'm coming. Listen, you get changed and come out. And I'll keep the cop busy while you leave.
Okay.
Good luck.
Yeah.
Sorry, I took so long, but I got her to buy something in the long run.
Good. When you finish, see to that lady over there. She's been waiting a while.
Yeah, sure. Here you are, madam. I hope you're happy with it.
Thank you. I'm sure I will be.
Oh,
Oh, looks like someone's trying to knock something off.
Deirdre, come on. Well, this is in your line of work, isn't it? What are you trying to do, Matt? Trying to take something out of the shop? Come on, we'll have to look at here. We'll have to get the sort of
detective
in here.
Looks like, they might be a bit of a...
True. Fancy getting your kicks from going through all that dirty stuff.
Quiet.
Are you going to be much longer? I've got a few other calls to make this morning, you know.
No, we won't be long. I could make the time go faster for you, darling.
Me too.
I said keep quiet, and that means all of you.
Anything? All right. Come on, you lot, get this stuff into the laundry.
Hey, Nola, how come they didn't find any of that stuff that we were supposed...
Shut up, will you, or they will.
Yeah, it's a wonder they didn't find the you-know-what that I asked me old folks to smuggle in.
Daniels.
This is for you.
Come off it. What are you trying to do? Get me in trouble?
Oh, go on, please. Just for me.
Thank you. I'll take it. Surprised at you, McKenzie. Think you'd get away with a stupid trick like... Oh, yes, yeah. That's really very funny, isn't it? Right, you get this laundry inside before I change my mind and put you on a charge.
It goes for everyone. Get moving.
Hey, I called Roxanne. She's going to be sending in some stuff real soon.
Good.
I have told you once. Okay, Daniels, you can do the pickup from the laundry inside.
Yes, Mrs. Powell.
Driscoll House.
Erica Davidson, Judy.
Oh, hi, Mrs. Davidson. How are you? What can I do for you?
Well, actually, I was hoping you could do something for Lainey Dobson. I'm afraid she tried to get rid of her tattoos with caustic soda.
What? Oh, God, when did this happen?
Yesterday. She's just arrived back from the hospital. Apparently, she'll be all right, but I would like you to have a word with her.
Yes, of course. Listen, have you spoken to Mr. Douglas about the tattoo program?
Yes, I have, but unfortunately the cost is extremely high, and as you know, Lainey won't even be with us for much longer.
Do you mean to say they're not going to do it?
I'm afraid not.
Well, isn't that fantastic? And they give you all sorts of money for furniture and stuff like that, but when it comes to something worthwhile...
Judy, I'm sorry, but I did what I could.
Oh, it just makes me so damn mad, that's all. Sorry, Mrs. Davidson, can I come in and see you today?
Yes, of course.
Thanks very much. Bye. Those bastards.
Hey, what about that big tit stuff on the van?
Yeah, didn't know which way to look, did he?
G'day, Maxine.
G'day, Lizzie.
Our legs are all
bloody. Hey, lady, I thought you... What the bloody hell have you done to yourself? You look like you've been in a real blue.
Tried the caustic soda.
What? Oh, crikey, lady, that stuff eats into you like... Well, I guess you found that out. You're hurting real bad.
It's still there.
Hey?
It's still there.
Real sorry, mate.
Oh, Mrs. Powell, is it done? I'd like you to speak to the women for me, please. I'm rather tied up at the moment.
Yes, of course. What about?
I want you to tell them their mail will no longer be censored.
Oh, look, I'm sorry. Is that wise at the moment? We might pick up something about the dope that's being smuggled in.
Exactly.
Oh, I see. You think they may be less cautious if they think no one else is reading it?
Yes. One of them might drop something about the drugs or even the supplier. It's worth a try.
Yes, it's a good idea. I'll see to it straight away.
There is one more thing. I know it's not particularly pleasant, but I want all officers searched as they enter the prison.
Oh, that won't be popular.
I realise that, but there is still the possibility one of them may be involved. If so, I want her caught.
I reckon her burns must be real bad because she just sort of lay there and didn't say nothing.
Poor little bugger. I wonder what mongrel gave her that rotten stuff.
Well, I don't know. I tried to talk her out of it when she asked me, but I never thought all she'd right. go and do...
You can stop work for a moment. Those of you who were working. You'll be pleased to know that the mail will no longer be censored.
Oh, Ripper!
How come, Mrs. Pear?
It's a restriction the department feels can be lifted. So that's their new policy.
Judy, I have already told you the department has turned it down.
Yeah, but that's because of the cost, isn't it?
Yes, mainly, but also because some of the methods have been rather disappointing. The women are left feeling worse off than they were before.
Yeah, okay, but look, I've heard of a new way of getting rid of tattoos. They've been using it at one of the girls' homes.
I see. What is involved?
It's good. What you do is you tattoo over the existing tattoo with bleach.
And it works?
Well, according to everything I've heard, it works really well. Best ever.
There's no scarring?
Well, there might be some little thing, but you can usually get rid of that with vitamin E cream.
Well, it sounds promising.
You're going to like the price, too. $130 for 100 tattoos.
Well, the department certainly can't complain about that. But don't get your hopes up too high. I'm not promising anything.
Well, I don't see how they can knock it back. I mean, it's the best rehabilitation scheme I've heard of.
Well, nothing so far. Mind you, all of these were written before they knew censorship was off.
Before we lied to them, you mean?
If they didn't try and put it across us, it wouldn't be necessary, would it?
I suppose not.
I mean, what's going on around here? I just had my bag searched at the gate.
Oh, yeah, that's right. You'd left for lunch before I could tell you. It's a new regulation. All officers are to be searched on their way in.
Why?
Mrs. Davidson's orders. If it bothers you, I'd take it up with her.
Oh, it doesn't bother me. Of course, it won't affect those of us with nothing to hide, will it?
No, of course it won't.
I thought the women had been told their mail wouldn't be censored anymore.
Yeah, that's right, they were.
Helene, how you feeling?
I'll wait in the corridor.
Well, now what did you go and do a dumb thing like that for?
Well, what do you expect me to bloody well do after that interview? No one else had helped me. Now look at me. I'm scarred worse than before. No one gives a stuff about me.
That's not true, love. I care about you, and Alan cares.
Hasn't called for a long time.
Yeah, well, there's probably a very good reason for that. I'll tell you what. Why don't I go and see him? Find out what's going on.
What if he doesn't want to see me anymore?
Well, I'm sure that's not the case, but we'll never know until we try, huh? Lainey, please. Give me his address, love.
Hurry up, you lot. You should all be outside by now.
Not you, McKenzie. I want a word with you. It's about time we have a little chat about our partnership. I got the impression that that was over. Don't be stupid, McKenzie. You couldn't exist without me, and you know it. Now, the governor's already making things a bit difficult for your little enterprise, but I've got a piece of information that you need.
Like what?
Payment first, $30.
You've got to be joking.
You've got a choice, McKenzie. Pay up, or I take every cent you've got on you.
Good.
This one's a real little gem. They're still censoring your mail.
We've been told different.
They're just trying to con you, hoping you'll let something slip through about the drugs.
Bastards.
I thought you'd be interested.
Well, two can play at that game. Only I'll be one step ahead of them all the way.
Yeah, only if you've got someone like me with inside information. And don't you ever forget it.
Well, I sure hope that Alan character isn't going to throw her over. On top of everything else, that'd be the last straw.
Well, I'm glad she has your support, Judy. It will be a great help.
Yeah, she really needs her boyfriend, though. What sort of guy is he?
I'm afraid I couldn't say. I didn't have any contact with him.
Mrs. Powell?
I don't know. I can't keep up with all of them.
Yeah, okay. Nobody knows anything, right?
Can you see yourself out, Judy?
Yeah, but do you mind if I hang around for a while? I'd like to talk to the other women after their exercise period.
Well, it's only just started.
I don't mind waiting. I want to talk to them about the tattoo program.
Judy, there isn't any program yet. There may never be one.
I know that, but I want to get an idea of numbers, find out who's interested for the cause.
Very well. I can't see any harm in that. You can wait in the recreation room if you like. I don't think you need an escort for that.
I don't think so.
What was that all about?
I think Dobson's been asking for her friend. I hope it's not going to cause any more trouble.
Yes, 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 I understand your problems. But the point is, the stock was ordered for today, and we've got orders.
Mrs. Dennis.
Hold on, please. What is it, Doreen?
Now that it's not so busy, I was wondering if I could take my lunch.
What? Oh, all right.
Thanks, I appreciate it.
Yes. It'll have to do then, won't it? I'll expect them tomorrow, then. Damn manufacturers.
Where's Doreen?
Gone to lunch.
Oh, hell. Thanks a million.
Look, I can't keep an eye on her all the time. I'm supposed to be running a business, not a police station.
And I'm supposed to be doing my job, not chasing after customers. She could be talking to Smith by now.
Everything under control?
Certainly, Mrs. Powell.
Good. Listen, I want the women watched carefully. Don't make it too obvious, though.
Aye. Expecting any trouble?
Yes, always. However, we won't allow any to develop, will we?
I wonder what they're cooking up.
I reckon they're waiting for a bundle of dope to come sailing over the wall.
Yeah. Well, I wish it would, because a roach would go down real well.
Well, I'd hate to disappoint them seeing they're all geared up for strife. Just sit back and watch the action, ladies.
What the hell is she up to?
Dunno. But the fish sure are biting. And they're coming down the straight, and it's po-faced by a head, followed by the freak. And here they come, and they're heading towards the... Oh, no!
Sure, Mrs. Powell.
Are you collecting old cans now?
Okay, you've got your dog. It's a bit...
My Deidre, how's things?
Oh, a bit slack. Where have you been?
Lunch. Had yours yet?
No.
Oh, well, you look as though you could do with a break. Why don't you go and ask Mrs. Dennis? I'm sure she won't mind. You can't spend all your time working, you know.
Oh, that was real grouse, Nola. You got po-faced real twitchy. She'll be jumping at her own shadow next.
Yeah, I told you, didn't I? A few more days of this sort of aggro and things will be back to normal. But in the meantime, Bill's just the bloke to help us out.
What are you going to get him to do?
I don't know yet. But the fun's just beginning, kiddo. You ain't seen nothing yet.
The women were real pleased with the food parcel you sent in, Bill.
Glad you could use it.
Oh, no worries about that. We don't see much fancy stuff around here. Any chance of another of the same?
Yeah, I think I could arrange it.
Oh, good. Only I wouldn't worry about including the tea this time.
It was damn good tea. I thought you would have liked it.
Yeah. Well, sometimes it's a bit hard to get rid of. pass me a packet of fags, will you?
Just a minute.
Hey, what are you doing? I'll just give me your seat.
No passing goods to the prisoners. You should know that, McKenzie.
Oh, yeah. I forgot. Sorry about that, Bill. Everything gets searched these days. Now, what was I talking about? Oh, yeah, can you send in another food parcel? But don't worry about the tea.
Yeah, I'll get onto it straight away.
Okay, McKenzie, your time's up.
Oh, geez, we had so much to catch up on. It was real nice to see you, Bill. I'll be in touch real soon.
I'll see you out, Mr. McKenzie. Got to make sure you get out of here safely. You can wait for an escort.
Never mind about that, Birdsworth. Just get moving.
I'm coming, Lizzie.
Come on, Daniels. Miss Brown, hurry them up, please. Good heavens, what's that?
Was left at the gate for Daniels.
Daniels?
Mm.
Well, she's hardly the teddy bear type.
No, I would have thought she was more the teddy boy type.
I wonder.
You think so?
Yes, I do. And I can't let it go through, can I? Search it.
Right.
G'day. How's it going at the home away from home? Reformed any deros lately?
No, but there is a vacancy if you want to apply.
Hey, Judy.
Hello, girls.
What are you doing here? When did you decide to pay us a visit?
Well, I didn't know I was coming myself until this morning. I've been in visiting Lainey. You heard what happened to her, huh?
Oh, yeah, poor little kid. Is she all right?
Well, it depends what you mean, doesn't it? I mean, you have to be pretty desperate to pour caustic soda over yourself. I'll tell you one thing, she's going to get a hell of a lot more desperate till she gets rid of those tattoos once and for all.
Fat lot of chance she's got of doing that from this dump.
I don't know about that. You know, there's another way of removing tattoos. It's a lot cheaper and safer than the others.
Probably not cheap enough for the department to take up.
Yeah, that's true if it's just one person, but there are a hell of a lot of women in here with tattoos. Now, what do you say, girl? Should we give the department a nudge?
What do you want us to do?
All you have to do is just ask around, find out which women are interested in a tattoo program, and get them to sign this piece of paper.
Oh, like a sort of petition.
Yeah, sort of.
Cool, I reckon that's a ripper idea.
Good on you. Well, what do you say, Maxine? You're going to be the first one to sign?
Me?
Uh-huh.
Oh, I don't know, Jude. Them sort of things hurt like hell, don't they?
This one doesn't hurt at all, and anyway, you can always back out later. Come on.
Go on, love. Think of Lainey.
Yeah. All right, Lizzie.
Daniels, this came for you.
Oh, that'd be from Roxy. Great.
God, what's she been doing? Using it for a footy or something?
Crikey, there's a few bits of him missing. Hey, girls, he seems to have lost a bit of his stuffing. My, my, my. Fancy picking on a poor little teddy bear. I wish you could stay a bit longer, Jude. It's real lonely here sometimes without me. Max is a good little mate, but she's only a kid.
Huh. So I'm an oldie, is that right?
Well, I'm glad you could come and see Lainey. She needs somebody like you to look out for her.
Yeah, she needs a boyfriend too. I'm going to try and see him next week.
Good. Give Alan my best wishes, eh?
I will. Listen, what sort of guy is he?
Oh, lovely little fella. Really nice manners, if you know what I mean.
You think he's genuine about her?
Oh, yes. They were like a couple of lovebirds together. It was lovely to see him.
You don't think maybe he'd be the sort of guy to dump her when he got out of here?
Oh, no. He got himself put in here because of her. Not many blokes would do that. Must have been really embarrassing for him sometimes. Oh, I felt sorry for them when they chucked him out.
Yeah, well, this place isn't exactly the best place for romance.
Yeah, but why doesn't he come and visit? You don't suppose?
Of course. They won't even let him in. It'd be too embarrassing.
But he's got a right to come and visit. They can't stop him anyway.
I wouldn't fancy anyone's chances of trying to get past the freaking po-face.
Yeah.
I'll tell you one thing, though. He'll get more than a foot in the door next time, because I am going to be standing right next to him. We all know how stubborn I can be. Hi, Carol. Did I miss a car?
Yes.
60.
Food parcel for McKenzie. Didn't waste any time, did he? She only asked for it a couple of hours ago.
What's going on around here? Well, I suppose we'll just have to go through it.
Sure. Listen, shouldn't we have searched Bryant's bag too? I mean, you never know, do you?
Oh, damn. Ask the gate guard to do it, will you? I'll get on with this.
Oh, I don't know. Doesn't seem worth going on with somehow now Mr. Maxwell's gone.
Don't talk like that. You're going to keep at it until you understand every word that's put in front of you. Won't take you long, you'll
see. What's all this?
Oh, just having a smoke, Miss Ferguson.
We'll get back to work.
Oh, your friend was quick off the mark. He's already sent in that parcel you ordered.
Good. So when do I see it?
As soon as Mrs. Powell's satisfied there's nothing in it that shouldn't be.
Knowing Bill, I reckon it'd be a pretty big parcel. That should take a while.
I'll have that, Henley.
It's no use to you. Hasn't got any pictures.
Okay, start working.
Don't take any notice of her, love. She doesn't know anything about nothing.
That cops have an exciting life. Well, don't you reckon this is kind of dumb? Why are you tailing me 10 feet behind when I'm just going to the pictures? Why don't you come along with me?
Well,
it makes sense, doesn't it?
I suppose so. I got the feeling nothing's going to happen anyway. Perhaps you're not such a good friend of B. Smith's as they think.
Oh, yes, I am. But she's real clever. You know, she wouldn't come anywhere near me because she knows the cops would be sniffing around me somewhere. She's a real tricky lady. You know, the last time she escaped... Come on! The last time she escaped.
Martin! McKenzie!
Thanks, Miss Ferguson.
What's going on, McKenzie?
Nothing, Mrs. Powell.
I saw you change the jars. Why?
Oh, I thought Maxie's was different, that's all. I like the stuff that's supposed to taste like real fresh roasted coffee beans.
Oh, don't be ridiculous. They're all the same and you know it. Okay, give them to me.
Oh, and I was just gonna make a cup.
I reckon there really is a difference, you know.
Okay. Collect all the goods from the women, Miss Ferguson. They're going to have to be searched.
Oh, that's not fair, Miss Powell.
No, I'm quite happy with my coffee.
You heard what I said, so get on with it.
I reckon this is getting bloody ridiculous.
All this extra vigilance doesn't seem to be paying off, does it?
Not yet.
We won't find anything. That excuse McKenzie gave about the coffee wouldn't tug anyone in.
What are you getting at?
Too much has been happening. They know we're looking for dope.
How could they? Unless one of the officers is letting them in on what we're doing, that could be happening, of course.
Oh, no.
It's much more simple than that. They've been on to us ever since you searched the cells.
Perhaps.
Of course they have. You won't find anything now. You should have made things a lot tougher before they went this far.
Really looking forward to this. I've been waiting to see it for ages, haven't you? Two thanks. You can pay me later.
Thank you. Yes, please.
Yes, thank you.
On the inside, but I suppose you know that already. She's the sort of person you could rely on, you know, a real good mate. I'd like to see her again, talk about old times, but wouldn't want to get caught for harbouring an escaped criminal. Still, there's not much chance of that happening with you around, is there? She really was top dog, you know, all the time we was inside. Of course, there was always someone trying to take over from her, you know, knock her off. But none of them lasted for too long, if you know what I mean. Too many people, eh?
Yes, that's a good idea.
Oh, this is going to be real good. I like going to the pictures after work. How long you been a policewoman, Deidre?
Oh, a few years.
But it isn't all boring stuff like this, eh? Ever been involved in anything like they do on the telly?
Please, Doreen.
Well, have you? You know, shootouts and stuff like that?
I'll tell you about it later. We better keep the noise down. I think that woman left because of you.
Geez, did she? Sorry. Just got a bit carried away. Anyway, the movie's about to start, so I better shut up, hadn't I?
The man ran 30 metres before he was...
Come on, love.
I can't. It's too hard.
Apprehended. That means they copped him.
Oh.
Geez, will you take a look at this bear now? But they just about turned him inside out.
You just keep going.
Don't reckon there'll be much Nola's food parcel left after Po-Face just finished either. But it's worth it, Buck. She's really got him running ragged.
Shut up about Nola, will ya?
What's up with you?
I'm sick of hearing about her, that's all.
Well, why? She's got the screws dancing. That's the name of the game round here, isn't it?
That bitch is only out for herself. She only causes strife. And when she gets that dope back in here, that'll mean even more strife.
Oh, come on, Lizzie. A few puffs on a joint never hurt no one.
Knock off yakking about her, will you, while I'm in here? That's all I ask.
All right, don't get your wig wet.
Now, where were we up to, love?
Can we leave it for today? I've had enough.
All right. We'll do some more tomorrow. Okay. You got to keep it up regular. It's like riding a horse. Cole, look at this, will you?
What?
That doco we did on Wentworth. It's going to be on telly in a few minutes. Yeah. Trust those screws not to tell us. Come on, I'm not going to miss that for anything.
Well, we made it this far, but it's been a long time since I've seen you, Bea, and I've really missed you. I haven't got any mates like you or Lizzie or Jude up here, and it might be ages till we see each other again. So I thought maybe, if you're not in too much of a hurry, you could take this key and come to my flat during the day after I've gone to work. The cops will be following me, so you ought to be safe. Please try and make it.
Love, Doreen. Oh, P.S. Hope 2,000 will be enough. I'll get more if you want it.
Doreen.
We are told
young Mark Hayes not a bad-looking young fella, is he?
Oh, I was a bit too young for you, Lizzie. I reckon he's more my speed.
Don't you believe it? There's plenty of life for the old chook yet.
We decided.
Hey, look, there's Lainey.
To take our cameras to the scene with crime.
Pretty love.
So, we
are. There's Diane. Services. The old place doesn't look too bad, does it, with all that nice music playing?
How come they're showing all that stuff? Only had a few reading lessons, they're making it look like it's on all the time.
Yeah, we've got no doc on hand to show like that either.
Oh, that's a laugh. Me bikey posters, well, they were the first to go.
I told you it was a whitewashed job for the department. What did you expect?
Well, come on, we know what the place looks like. How about the interviews?
Maxine, I want to talk to you.
Yeah, in a minute, when this ball's finished.
Now.
There you are now, Lizzie.
All right, keep your hair on.
God, I'd have shot my mouth off a lot more if I'd known the buggers were gonna do that to us.
Wouldn't have made no difference. They'd only put in what they wanted. They don't give a stuff about us.
Well, what's that?
Well, what does it look like? I want you to see that it gets outside.
Well, why don't you send it the usual way? You heard po-face censorship's off.
You mob never learn, do you? That's just what they want us to think. It's just another con.
Hey?
And even if it wasn't, it's too much of a risk. It's my next dope order.
Well, what about me? How the bloody hell am I supposed to get it out?
Your mate Birdbrain.
Oh, you're joking, aren't you? She wouldn't be inside.
Look, you don't tell her what's in it. She's always skiting about how much she hates dope. Nobody's going to go through her mail. It'd be a breeze.
Well, I can't. I don't even know what sort of line I could spring her.
You'll think of something.
Well, it's not that easy putting something over Lizzie. And anyway, like you said, she's one of me mates.
You'll find a way. And be quick. I want that dope supply in here real soon. Got it?
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too, when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare of waking up alone. On the inside, the roses grow. They don't mind the stony ground, but the roses here are prisoners too. When morning comes around.